At this time, I would like to invite our speakers. They are the new generation and they are our future. The first one is the youngest one. He just come back from MD Anderson Cancer Center. Dr. Thitithep Warapithak, he will give us a talk in principle of oncologic resection in colorectal cancer. Dr. Thitithep, please.
Thank you, Ajahn Chirawat, for an introduction. Welcome all colleagues from every country. Our theme today is overcoming challenges in laparoscopic colorectal cancer surgery. My topic today will be on principle of oncologic resection in colorectal cancer. We all know that surgery is the curative treatment for localized cancer. To do the surgery for colon and rectal cancer, the aim of surgery are first, complete tumor removal. Second is completion of the primary vessel resection. And third is complete removal of the lymphatic drainage. This including pericolic lymph node, intermediate lymph node, and central lymph node. These are overall basic principles that you must always consider when doing colon and rectal cancer surgery. I will separate my talk into two groups. First is the colon cancer and second is the rectal cancer, but I will emphasize on colon cancer much more than rectal cancer because there's so many interesting points in the oncologic principle of colon cancer resection, much more than rectal cancer resection. First thing you need to know when you're dealing with the colon cancer surgery is the concept of complete mesocolic excision or CME and the central vascular ligation or CVL. These concepts were proposed by Hohenberger back in 2009. They report the reduction in 5-year local recurrence from 6% down to 3% and report the increase of the 5-year cancer-related survival almost 10%. First is the complete mesocolic excision. They describe this technique by sharp dissection in between the visceral fascia and parietal fascia of the colon and colon mesentery. The aim of this technique is to keep the intact mesenteric integrity, and the extent of dissection will be determined by the tumor location and the pattern of lymphatic spreading. Back then, they would do extensive, like in right side colon, they will cauterization duodenum and pancreas up to dissect around the SMA vessels, and then take down the duodenum and pancreas again to dissect all around SMA. But that would be too extensive, so there is modification of this technique nowadays, so we do less and less invasive. The benefits of doing CME would be has been shown in the population-based study in 2015. They show that the disease-free survival was higher in the group that do CME than the group that do conventional surgery. The hazard ratio is 0.59, which you can gain almost 10% of the survival. Next concept that Hohenberger proposed is central vascular ligation. In their description, they said that to do the vascular division at the origin of the feeding vessels, like in if you have to cut allocolic vessel, you have to identify the SMA and SMV and then cut the allocolic vessel at the origin. But the details of lymphadenectomy that was described is not clearly defined. The interesting point that Hohenberger proposes is transverse colon because they not only do the central ligation of middle colic vessel, but also do some extra mesenteric vessel ligation and extra mesenteric lymphadenectomy, also for the left side colon. Now, similar technique has been proposed from Japanese side. They call it D3 dissection. The lymph node that they want to do the D3 dissection is the main lymph node. You will see the green color lymph node. Here is the main lymph node. The purple color is intermediate lymph node along the feeding vessel, and the yellow color is the pericolic lymph node along the marginal artery nearby the tumor. This diagram shows the need, the spreading of the pericolic lymph node defined by distribution of the feeding artery. There's a lot of detail about the lymph nodes, the feeding in the journal, but which percentage margin if the feeding vessel is running into the tumor. Okay, and the extent of the lymphadenectomy in this feeding vessel, it would be called D2 dissection. If you extend the lymphadenectomy like IMA, it would be called D3 dissection. But the definition or the end of dissection are different in between institution. Even in Japan, they do differently. So you have to look into the detail when we read through the study. Some institution they both SMV and SMA, but some institution will do only anterior side of SMV. So you have to look through the detail because there is a little technical differences between the institution. Now for D3 dissection, they will separate into the tumor location. If you do type colon cancer, D3 dissection, as in the picture, you will see that you have to retrieve the lymph node to trunk down to SMA, the anterior lymph node that was anterior in anterior part of SMA has to be dissected. And for left colic and left colon and sigmoid colon, lymph node around IMA must be retrieved. Now the differences between CME plus CVL and Japanese D3 dissection. They summarize that the term of the CME and CVL, they didn't specify the dissection at the origin of the feeding vessel, and the length of bowel removed in the western side would be 10 centimeters margin, but in Japanese side they do less than 10. Normally they do less than 10 centimeters margin. And routine extra mesenteric lymph node dissection was not done in Japanese guideline. And the benefit of extended lymphadenectomy, why should we do D3 dissection or why should we do the central vascular ligation to remove all these lymph nodes? First thing is it improves accuracy of lymph node evaluation because there are some central lymph node positivity around 1 to 8% reported in the literature. And if we do the extended lymphadenectomy, we could accurately staging this lymph node. And there's report about the if the central lymph node was positive for malignancy, the survival of patient will be worse than the group that does not have central lymph node metastasis. But we do not recommend to do extended lymphadenectomy in all cases because it's not 100% that you have the central lymph node metastasis. As I said in the last slide, that is only up to 8%. And the skip metastasis, I mean, if you do not have the clinical node positive in imaging or in intraoperative field, the percentage of skip metastasis would be only 2%. So the benefit is not that high, so we do not recommend to do in all cases. You have to select the case that has the lymph node metastasis in preoperative imaging. Now, after we know the benefit, after we know the concept, we have to know that which vascular should be ligated. There's a study of the Korean group that they study the lymph node station, the percentage of the metastasis. If the tumor is in cecum, the lymph node may be mainly around the cell, the leg, but no lymph node metastasis. This allow the middle colectomy, right hemicolectomy, like a large middle colic artery. But in there's a variation of lymph node metastasis. You also have to do the paleocolic artery ligation, lycolic artery ligation, and light branch of middle colic ligation. About the hepatic flexor and proximal transverse colon cancer, there's a chance that that the middle colic trunk will have the lymph node metastasis. So the recommendation would be extended right hemicolectomy artery and middle colic trunk. Another study from Japanese group, they also study for the left side colon cancer. The distal transverse colon can have the lymph node metastasis up to 33% to the left branch of middle colic. So their recommendation would be to ligate the left branch of middle colic. If the tumor is in this descending colon, the lymph node will be along the left colic artery and the first branch of sigmoidal artery. So the recommendation would be to ligate only left colic artery, because the first branch of sigmoidal artery mainly they arising from the left colic artery. And if the tumor is in sigmoid colon, there's a higher chance that the lymph node will be lymph node metastasis will be up to a level. So normally for sigmoid and rectum, we have to do the dissection around IMA to clear all the lymph nodes or the central lymph node. And the resection margin, as certain country will do 10 centimeters for both proximal and distal margin, because there's a low chance that beyond 10 centimeters, there's a tumor, both tumor migration and the colic lymph node metastasis. But in Asian country or a newer trend, we try to limit the length of proximal and distal margin, because like in this study, they study the distance between tumor and the resection margin. They found that only 5 centimeters from proximal margin and distal margin would be sufficient for the standard resection. Because because the survival is not different in the, I mean, if you extend the margin to 10 centimeters, it's not different. It depends on the vertical resection that you do. I mean, if you do standard D2 dissection with 5 centimeters, good enough. Here is the recommendation from this group, the removal of 5 centimeters of normal bowel on both proximal and distal side of primary tumor with dissection of intermediate lymph. No, this means standard D2. Along the feed artery was an essential is biologically aggressive, like in T4 tumor, or is a polydipsic cancer, or there is this kind of metastasis. The chance of longer spreading can you have to keep in mind that this situation can happen. Now, for the conclusion of the colon resection, I recommend that you should do first is lymphadenectomy. You can do standard D2 dissection, lymphadenectomy, or D3 dissection in selected case. The case that recommend from the review is the clinically lymph node positive. If you see that there are many lymph nodes around the vessel, the feeding vessel, you can extend your lymphadenectomy. The routine extended lymphadenectomy is not recommend because the survival benefit is low comparing with the morbidity. It is not worth to do in every cases. Next step, after you do the lymphadenectomy, you should ligate the feeding vessel according to the tumor location, as I mentioned earlier. And then you consider the proximal and distal margin resection. I recommend to do at least 5 centimeters according to the both ASCRS guideline and Japanese guideline. And you have to also do the complete mesocolic excision in every cases. Now for the surgical resection of the rectal cancer, and this concept is quite popular for like more than 20 years now. Everyone will do this, the TME concept in rectal cancer surgery. The concept is to do sharp dissection into the TME plane. In this picture, the blue dot line will be the TME plane. You will see that the important part would be anterior side of the mesorectum fat, because you will see the anterior mesorectum is thinner than this, the lateral side or the posterior side. So it's hard to determine. In this picture, it may be easier. But in real MRI or in real cases, it will not be this easy to do the dissection into TME planes. You have to be very precise, because if you going into the TME plane, black into the TME plane, the survival of the patient gonna be worse. And the resection margin of the rectal cancer is quite settled. You have two margin to be considered. First is distal margin, and the second one is the circumferential resection margin. About the distal resection margin, you have to wait between local recurrence and the sphincter preservation. If you want to preserve sphincter in the case that is not proper, you may face with the local recurrence instead. So you have to weigh the risk and the benefit of the sphincter preservation. There are two recommendations, two guidelines for rectal cancer resection from ASCRS and from the Japanese group. The rectal sigmoid cancer and upper rectum cancer, they recommend to do tumor-specific mesorectal excision with the distal resection margin at least 3 centimeters in the middle rectum and lower rectum, they recommend to do total mesorectal excision with the distal margin of 2 centimeters in Japanese guideline. But in ASCRS, they recommend that if tumor located at or below shorten the distal margin to 1 centimeters. I will skip this because it's the after radiation. Sorry. So another margin that you need to consider is resection margin, because we are here less than 1 millimeter, the much higher, and the distant metastatic rate would be much less than the TME plane. But in some tumor, if the operative imaging show that the CRM was threatened, you might need to consider the extended resection, or you might need to do the multivisceral resection of the adjacent organ also. So if you respect the TME, then you keep the distal margin to get a good circumferential resection margin, the oncologic outcome would be better. But I think the hardest part of the rectal cancer resection is not their oncologic principle, because we know this principle for so long, but the hardest part would be how to do it nicely, because some tips and techniques that you need to know to do it better, and it will be shown in next topic. Oh, okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Thitithep. You did a very good job